Let us study the remaining three operators, namely left shift, right shift, and bitwise exclusive OR. This is the same program. We know that we have declared A, B, and C three variables. They are of integer type, and we have initialized these variables by the values 1, 2, and 3 respectively. Result is a fourth variable. It's again integer type of variable. Now let us study left shift bitwise operator. This operator is denoted by less than sign. So there are two less than signs. Now see, content of the variable C is 3. And that is why the binary equivalent of this number is 0000011. Now shift this binary number by applying left shift operator. Now 1 denote we are shifting 1 bit. So left shift by 1 bit. So after this, the first bit will shift it to the second one, second position, and second bit will be shifted to the third bit. And that is why one more bit will be inserted from left, and the content of that bit is 0. And hence the outcome is 0000 0110. And now this is the binary equivalent of the decimal number 6. And hence, after left shift by 1 bit, the variable result will contain the number 6. Is it clear? Now, let us study the right shift operation. Now see, content of C is 3. And hence, the binary equivalent of this decimal number 3 is 0000 0011. Now apply the right shift operator and shift it by 1 bit. So 1 sandbar, 1 bit. And greater than sign, 2 greater than signs means right shift. Clear? Now apply the right shift operator. It's a bitwise operator. And hence what happened is that this first bit will be shifted to the right, and that is why it is truncated, and second bit will become your first bit. That is why the result is 0000 0001, and hence what is it exactly? It is 1, decimal number 1. 0000 0001, it is a binary equivalent of the decimal number 1. And hence, after this operation, after right shift operation, the content of the result will be 1. Clear? Understood this working? Well, now let us study bitwise exclusive OR operator. So before studying this operator, let us see the truth table of bitwise exclusive OR operator. So C is a one variable, A is another variable. If you apply bitwise exclusive OR operator, caret sign, then we'll get, when C is false and A is false, we'll get false. True, bitwise exclusive operator OR, F, will get true. C is false, if you apply bitwise operator over it, and if A is true, then we'll get true. And true, bitwise operator exclusive OR true, will we get false. Understood the working of this bitwise exclusive operator? Understood the truth table of bitwise exclusive operator? Bitwise exclusive OR operator, Okay, now let us apply this operator. So content of C is 3. And content of A is 1. That is why if you apply this truth table, if you apply this operator over C and A, I mean C bitwise exclusive OR A will get this value. Let us study it. Now we know that, let us study this case, true, false, true. So this is true, this is false, and hence will get true, because true, false is true in case of bitwise exclusive OR, and hence the outcome of this operator is 1. Now apply this operator to the first bit, you see 110. So this is the case number 4, that is true, true, false. Hence first bit is true, first bit of variable A is true, and hence outcome is false, that is 0, and hence resultant is 0000010, and this is nothing but binary equivalent of the decimal number 2. And hence after this bitwise exclusive OR operation, the content of the result will be 2. Understood the bitwise operators? Thank you.